ओम्स लॉ। In electricity, this is very important one, a very fundamental law we can say. It gives the relation between potential difference and current. How potential difference depend on current, or how current depend on potential difference. That is given by this law. Statement is given in your book. So according to this law, what is said? If there is no change in the physical condition, means there is no change in the dimension of the conductor, no change in the temperature, mainly the temperature. If there is no change in the temperature, then what will be the potential difference across two terminal of the conductor will be directly proportional to current passing through it. No, for example, suppose, or reverse may be also possible. How much current will pass through the conductor, that will depend on the potential difference. For example, suppose you are using a bulb which is a torch bulb in which three cells are required. If you connect that same bulb with one cell only, suppose we are using only one cell and connecting that bulb, what will happen? Nothing. You will not be able to see that filament is even red or not. There will be no change will be noticed. If you use two cell you will observe the filament is becoming red. It is giving very less light. Why is it so? Current is less, but current has increased from the previous one. Previous one current was very less. Now when you apply one more cell, now the bulb is full blue. What does it mean? The current will keep on increasing as you increase the potential difference. Well, only one cell was there, that is 1.5 volt we have applied. Two cell we have connected, 3 volt we have applied. But it requires 4.5 volt for full blue. That means whatever current is required for that bulb for full glow, that will be given by these three cells, that is 4.5 volt. So this is given in the form of law by Ohm's law. So generally we say if temperature is constant or at constant temperature, or if there is no change in the physical condition. So at constant temperature, potential difference across any conductor is directly proportional to current passing through it. It may be opposite also. That is, at constant temperature, current passing through conductor is directly proportional to potential difference across it. That is, how much current will pass through a conductor, that will depend on sorry potential difference across it. So, or it can be current passing through a conductor is directly proportional potential difference across its two terminals. So we can express in these two ways. According to this law, we say potential difference is directly proportional to current. Well, if there is no change in physical condition, no change in material. So as it is mentioned here, directly across any conductor. So if you are not changing any dimension, then only conductor is same. If you change the dimension, different conductor. So mainly what is the change? Constant temperature should be constant. Temperature should not change. If temperature is constant. According to this, what we get? This current is directly proportional to V if temperature is constant. So both are valid, both are the law. Now, as we know, when we remove this proportionally constant, what we are doing? We are applying
E2K.
Hey, sorry, when we remove this proportional relation, we have to give
E2K
a proportionality constant. So either you use this or this, the constant will be different. For different relation, constant will be different. So if you are using the first one, if this V is directly proportional to I, if we are using this, or at constant temperature. So in this case, we will say the proportionality constant, when we remove this proportionality relation, the constant given here is R. So this R we call resistance of the conductor.
Look a little down.
What? Yeah, coming. Now, if we use another one, if second relation we are using, I is directly proportional to V at constant temperature, or if temperature is constant. Now, here, if we remove this proportionality constant, proportionality relation, The constant is coming C. C is what? Conductance. And which is equal to 1 by R into V. C is conductance. So it is given by the inverse of resistance.
Or can you tilt your camera a little bit down? Down.
Down. It is not there, down.
Yes.
So from both the relation we are getting same thing. Here V is IR, here also V is IR. The same relation. Either we explain the law in terms of this, or we explain in terms of this, the final relation is same. That is, potential difference across any conductor is given by the product of current passing through it and the resistance of the conductor. So from both the relation we are getting the same thing. That is, V is I into R. This is the mathematical expression of Ohm's law. This is it. Temperature is constant. Or if temperature is not constant, naturally this R will change. At any temperature, we can apply this. So at that particular temperature, this R will change. Okay, now we have to. Okay. Visible?
A little more up, sir.
Yes, sir.
Sir, you keep your camera a little bit far, so everything will be visible.
Little bit far, then what will be? Then words will be very small. That is the problem, no? It is a little far, then. Is it clear?
Sir, yes, do sir. Your camera little up, sir.
What? This part?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
So what you have written there?
Yes.
Down where C is the dash.
C is the conductance. C is conductance of the conductor. And C is equal to 1 by R. We have done this one, this part.
C yes, is sir.
Inverse of resistance. Conductance is inverse of resistance. And what is sigma? What is this? What do we call this?
Rho.
Rho. What is this?
Rho.
In this chapter, what is the symbol? What is the meaning? resistivity
rough material
or specific resistance. This one is conductivity or specific conductance. This is also inverse of this. No? C is inverse of R, sigma is inverse of rho. These all we have done in previous class. Okay. So, whether you consider first statement or second statement, the general is what? V will be equal to IER. Potential difference is given by the product of current and resistance of the conductor. This is the mathematical expression of Ohm's law. Now, in class 10, you have done the equation of a straight line, y equal to mx plus c. No. This you have done or not done till now? Quadrant geometry? No. Done.
Sir, this we have.
No, sir.
No. Okay.
No, sir.
So here, when we draw a graph of proportionality one, in class 9 we have done distance equal to speed into time. No.
Yes, sir.
Yes. What was the graph? Distance versus time graph? When speed is constant, distance versus time graph was what time? That was a straight line inclined to both directions. Yes, and passing through origin. If at t equal to 0, distance is 0. That is when we start observing the particle, that is the origin. Then we will come pass through the origin only. Now, what was the slope of this graph? The slope of this graph gives speed. No. Yes. You have done class 9.
Yes, sir. Speed or velocity.
Yes. Speed or velocity given by the slope. Now, similar relation is here also. In place of S, V is coming. In place of U, suppose this I is coming. In place of T, I is coming. T is the variable. So, current is variable. And in place of U, this R is coming. So, if we plot this V versus I graph, here, what is that? In place of S, V is coming. In place of U, R is coming. In place of P, I is there. So, if we plot V versus I graph, this will also a straight line similar graph. So, this graph will be a straight line inclined to both the axes. Whenever any relation, proportional relation is there, the graph will be a straight line inclined to both the axes. It may pass through the origin, it may not pass through the origin. Here, suppose example here, if at t equal to 0, particle was not at origin, it was somewhere else. Then it will start from here like this. It may come like this. Ut plus, suppose some distance was there. Then this will be the x naught at t equal to 0, position was x naught, t equal to 1, x naught plus ut, t equal to 2, x naught plus 2u, okay, whatever it is. So, this way also, here also it will be like this. But here, when current is 0, potential difference will be 0. So, graph will not pass through anywhere else. It will pass through origin only. provided you have taken the origin. Sometimes we don't take 0, 0 as origin. Somewhere else we are starting the graph. In that case, it may not pass through origin. Now, what will be the slope of this graph?
Resistance.
Delta V over delta I. So this part will give delta V. And what is the change in potential difference? This part will give delta I. So this slope is delta V by delta I. And this will give resistance of the conductor. So if V is directly proportional to I, that means graph should be straight line. And indirectly, if you want to verify Ohm's law, we are plotting the graph. In the lab, we have to verify Ohm's law. So how will we verify? We'll plot V versus I graph. If this graph is coming straight line inclined to both the axes, then we will say V is directly proportional to I. That means Ohm's law is valid. Or practically, we can verify it. Now, suppose if we plot if we consider another relation, that was I is equal to C into V. That was according to second statement. I is 1 by R into V. 1 by R means conductance. So if we take I on Y axis and V on X axis, that is V we are varying, like we are adding the battery in the first example what was given. In that case, we are adding battery. First one battery, whatever current is passed, we will measure. Add one more battery. What is the current? We will observe. So what we are observing, that we are taking on Y axis. What we are knowing from before, that we are taking on X axis, that we have done in class 8 also while plotting the graph, or in class 9 you might have we have discussed what is on Y axis, what is on X axis, and how we write the graph. This graph will write V versus I graph. Always we write Y versus X graph. So what you are plotting on Y axis, that is this side. What you are plotting on x-axis, that is this side. So here, current is known from before. How much current is passing through that we are knowing. And we are going to measure potential difference. That is, potential difference is to be observed. So this will be plotted on y-axis, this will be plotted on x-axis. Here, potential difference we are knowing from before. So if we plot a graph, what type of graph will come here? This is the relation. What type of graph will come? Yes. Again, straight line. V equal to IR. Similar relation is here. V equal to R into I. No, V equal to R into I. So this is the constant. This is on Y axis, this is on X axis. Similarly here, this is on Y axis, this is on X axis. So this is also proportional graph. So this will also a straight line inclined to both the axes. Now, what will be given by the slope of this graph? Slope means 10 theta that we have done in class 9. 10 theta means perpendicular by base. That is slope of the graph. So here perpendicular is what? Delta I. This is delta I here. And this is delta V. Delta V you will find from the y-axis. Sorry, x-axis. So what are you reading corresponding to this? Suppose here is 10 volt. Here is 2 volt. Then 10 volt minus 2 volt. 8 volt is the delta V. Here current is 10 milliampere. Here current is 50 milliampere. Then 50 minus 10, that is 40 milliampere is the delta I. So if you find this delta I by delta V, what will get?
Conductance.
Slope of this I versus V graph will give conductance. Whereas the slope of V versus I graph, this symbol we say versus. We say V versus I graph. Gives resistance. Understood?
Yes.
So both the graph, sometimes in the question paper, this graph is given, sometimes that graph is given. So before writing the conclusion, just you check which graph is given, whether it is V versus I graph or I versus V graph. Now, why this condition is here applied at constant temperature? Because we know when temperature changes, resistance of conductor will change. Naturally, that relation V versus I or V by I will not be constant. So this R, which is equal to V by I, is constant. If there is no change in temperature. Similarly, this C, which is I by V, is constant if there is no change in temperature. So indirectly, this is the limitation of Ohm's law. If this is constant, then only we say V is proportional. Now, suppose this R is given by V by I. If potential difference is doubled, what will be the effect on R? Yes. R is given by V by I. If potential difference become twice, what will be the effect on resistance? No one.
Will become half.
It become half. When V is doubled, then what will become half? Who is this great person?
It will double, sir.
Yes.
It will become twice.
It will be twice. That is the general concept. So it is 100% wrong one. What we have learned just now?
Sir, C will double.
C will double.
Yes, sir.
when V double, then how C will double? Just now we have learned, we have discussed potential difference is directly proportional to current, or current is directly proportional to potential difference. So what does it mean? When you make the potential difference double, current will also be double. This ratio of V and I will be constant. Resistance does not depend on V or I. We have done the factor, no, of resistance. Anywhere did it come? V or I? Resistance
no,
depend
sir.
On what? Dimension of the conductor. No? Resistance is depending on length of the conductor, area of cross-section of the conductor, nature of the material, okay. And temperature. These are the four factors on which resistance depend. Resistance does not depend on V or I. Conductance does not depend on I or V. If you increase I, same ratio, with the same ratio, V will also increase. So there will be no change in the. So this R and C neither depend on V nor on I. So it will remain constant. If you increase V or I, R will not change. If you change the temperature, then only it will change. And when you change the temperature, this ratio is not constant. Naturally, Ohm's law is not valid. So we say the Ohm's law, the limitation of Ohm's law is is valid till there is no change in temperature. So indirectly we say it is valid only for small current, because when we pass current through any conductor, due to resistance, energy will be converted into heat and there will be rise in temperature. So, therefore we say Ohm's law is valid only for small current. So practically, when we do this in the lab, you will be told not to increase the current beyond 0.8 ampere. If you go beyond that, the wire will become hot. And once the temperature of wire changes, the ratio will not get constant. So indirectly, we say Ohm's law is valid only for small current. If you increase the current, naturally, what will happen?
Temperature will
increase. Due to resistance, temperature of the conductor will rise. And hence, this ratio will not be constant. Sorry, we will not get the VI graph, straight line inclined to both the axes, or I versus V graph, straight line inclined to both the axes. Okay, so we will leave up to here. Next day we shall see the verification of Ohm's law. Yes. Shall we do up to here?
Thank you, sir.